Hello friends, welcome to my channel once again. Today in my Fourier series lectures I shall obtain the Fourier series expansion for a function, a step function. I have given the function here. You can see that fx is equal to minus k in the region of minus pi to 0, and fx is plus k, that is positive k, in the region of 0 to pi, and the function is periodic. So I have written that, and after getting the Fourier series expansion for this step function, I also have to deduce this formula, this thing. So you can see our function, I have plotted that it is a step function, and this is k, this is minus k, and from 0 to k, from minus pi to 0, we have minus k, and from 0 to pi, we have k. You can see it. So let's find the Fourier series expansion. Well, we know that we can write the Fourier series in this formula. Here fx is equal to minus k in the region of minus pi to 0, and equal to k for 0 to pi. So a 0, it would be 0. You can see that, but I am still finding it. So minus limit would be minus pi to 0. I am taking k common, so it would be dx, and it would be 0 to pi dx, and it will be 0. You can check. So minus of minus pi plus pi, so it is 0, and a n would also be 0 because it will be sine terms in the limit of minus pi to 0 and 0 to pi. So sine 0 is 0, and sine n pi is obviously 0, so it would be also 0. So you can check also. I am taking k out of the integration, so I am writing this minus pi to 0 sine of nx dx plus cos of nx dx, and it would be 0 to pi cos of nx dx. So integration of cos nx will produce sin nx, and as I have mentioned that the sin terms will be 0 when the angle would be 0, minus pi and pi. So you can see I am still finding it, minus pi to 0, and it would be sin n pi n sin nx by n 0 to pi. So as you can see, it would be 0. Now let find bn, which is, again I am taking k out of the integration, so this time I have to write minus pi to 0 sin nx dx plus 0 to pi sin nx dx. So simple integration, you can do it. So minus sign would be positive, so I am writing cos nx by n, and the limit is minus pi to pi 0, and it would be minus cos nx by n 0 to pi. So ultimately I am finding cos 0 by n minus of cos n pi minus n pi. So this is, and this is cos n pi by n minus cos of 0 by n. Well, so this is 2k by pi, and cos 0 would be 1, so 1 by n, and here is, it would be minus of minus 1 whole to the power n, because since cos minus n pi is equal to cos n pi equal to minus 1 whole to the power n. So this is the value of bn. Okay, so we can write our function fx as 2k by pi. Look that for n, look that when n is an even number, this bn term will be 0, it will vanish. So I will get bn values only for when n is an odd number. So I can write it like this: n is equal to 1 to infinity, and when n is an odd number we will get 2 from this term. So I can write twice by n sin this would not be n simply, so I should write 2n minus 1, so that I will get only the odd numbers here. So sin 2n minus 1x. So finally take out this 2 out of the integration summation. So I can write it like this: sin 2n minus 1x divided by 2n minus 1. That's it. Now we have to deduce this thing, the summation, this. So let's find that. We know from the problem that fx is equal to k in the region of 0 to pi. So let's put x equal to pi by 2. So in that case, so f pi by 2 would be k, that would be equal to 4k by pi summation n equal to 1 to infinity sin 2n minus 1 pi by 2 2n minus 1. Look, when n is equal to 1, sin we will get sin pi by 2, and that would be 1, and when n equal to 2 we will get sin 3 pi by 2, that is equal to minus 1, and so on. So we can write it summation n equal to 1 to infinity divided by 2n minus 1, and we can write it minus 1 n plus 1. So when n equal to 1 we are getting plus 1, and when n equal to 2 then we are actually getting 3 pi by 2, which is minus 1. So n equal to 2 would produce minus 1, and n equal to 1 is producing plus 1. So this is right. So we can write that pi by 4 is equal to summation n equal to 1 to infinity minus 1 whole to the power n plus 1 divided by 2n minus 1. we were supposed to prove this, and finally we have proved that also. So hope you have understood the problem. I have taken one step function defined by this in the region given here, and you can see the plot of the step function, and I was supposed to get the Fourier series expansion, and you can notice that a0 and an would be 0. I have only got bn, and I have finally got the Fourier series expansion here, and we also have found this thing which we were supposed to deduce. So let me show you another thing. Let's see how does this function, this Fourier series, look like. For that I will open one software app, graph plotting app. So here is Desmos, and I have to get the Fourier series plotted here. So let me remind the series first. So we had 4k by pi and this thing. Okay, let's try. So let's write 4k, let me use the keyboard, 4k divided by pi, and there was summation. So summation n equal to 1, and let it be 10. I will increase the upper limit of the summation so that we can get a really huge number, high number. The summation should be n equal to 1 to infinity. So let's try with 10 first and see what happens. So sin 2n minus 1 x divided by 2n minus 1, and I have to give the value for k, so it is a bit higher, 2.8. so you can see that I have got the plot, and a lot of fluctuation is there. It is step function but with some fluctuations. So if we increase first, let me decrease the value of the upper limit. So let it put 2. So you can see that when n is equal to 1 to 2, we are not getting that step function quite well. It looks like step function, but the sine terms are dominating. So you can see. So for that, we have to increase the upper limit. So it is 20. Now look, it is better than 10 and obviously 2, but still we have some fluctuations. You can see it. So if we further increase 10 times, then let's see what happens. So some problem has occurred. Let me reduce. Yeah, now you can see that function looks better, even better. So you can understand the thing that why n is 1 to infinity. Whenever we will increase the upper limit, we will get better results. So that's why the limit is n is equal to 1 to infinity. So here you can see that we have got better results. So again increase that value. So you can see that we are getting the things. So hope you have understood the problem and you can do the thing yourself also. I have already uploaded several videos on Fourier series expansion, and for that you can check the Fourier series playlist in my channel. And please consider subscribing my channel. If you have liked the video, please do like the video. And if you have some queries, some comment to do, then please make some comments and share the video. So stay tuned. With regards, myself, I am Sarkar. Thanks a lot.